Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go. Dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker.
Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from a beautiful and sunny day in Toronto. It is gorgeous outside. The bees are buzzing, and so are the cars, because it is the Honda Indy this weekend. So they have shut down the lakeshore, and there are cars speeding really fast along the lakeshore this weekend. So a busy, busy weekend in the city. But I'm happy to be home and spending some time with you. Ready to share some of the knitting that I've been up to this week. So it's been a busy week. I have been avoiding sweaters, but I've been getting some other things done, which has made me feel really, really good. So I'm excited to share. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. I noticed this week that I've had a few emails indicating that some new people have joined us. So if you are a new viewer, welcome. Thank you for coming and joining us on the Comfy Red Couch, which you will notice is not really red. It used to be until we switched it out. But we do have two beautiful new red comfy chairs just over to the side. Tasha is sitting on one, and the other day Nathaniel tried to move her and she swatted at him. So just if you choose to sit on the comfy red chair over there, just be careful. The cat does swat, but I would say that if the cat's sitting there, it's probably the best spot in the house. So welcome to anyone who is new. And for anyone who is returning, thank you so much for coming back to join me. This is episode 101. Last week, as I was editing, I realized that it was the 100th episode, and then did a little tag on in the epilogue to say thank you to everybody for joining me along this weekly ride that I do. Again, thank you so much for spending time with me every week. I really appreciate the time that you give me, and I hope that along that ride, you've been getting a lot of work done on your projects as well. So welcome back. And I know you have your requisite cup of whatever it is you're drinking today. I've decided to go hot, even though it is hot outside. They say that's good for you. I don't know. And I know you've got your project of choice. You've either picked a nice spot on the comfy white couch with the red blanket, or you've actually gone and decided to try out the new red chairs, and I'll pop a picture in so that you can see what they look like, because I'm not going to turn the camera. But yeah, it's nice. It actually opens the space up a little bit more, and Nathaniel, even though he says he doesn't like them, he seems to be cuddling in well when he is here, but he's not here today, so there's lots of space for you. Anyway, you have your requisite cuppa, you've got your project of choice, and you are ready to see what I have been up to this week, and hopefully you will have a chance to work on your project for a little bit. Anyway, let us move on to tea time. And I am drinking out of my Haunted Mansion mug. If you've tuned in before, you know I love this mug. This is a big mug of caffeine here. I haven't made myself a cup of tea in a couple of weeks, hot tea. I've been drinking lots of cold brew tea. I've been dabbling in the coffee a little bit this week. I've been making it for Greg and Isaac in the mornings. But I haven't made myself just a plain cup of tea. So today I thought that's what I was going to do. So I just have plain Marks and Spencer tea in my lovely Haunted Mansion mug. It's comfortable. It's classic. It's just perfection. And so for the week ahead, I am wishing you comfort. I am wishing you just all of the wonderful things and cozy time knitting or crocheting or whatever craft it is that you are doing. I'm just wishing you a wonderful week. So, cheers to a wonderful week. Before I move on, I actually want to share something that I picked up this week. I could save it for brown paper packages. It came in a really big box, which was kind of silly, but I purchased an OXO Good Grips bottle cleaner, and instead of sharing this on brown paper packages, I thought I'd share it in tea time because I've been using a lot of my Swell bottles for my cold brew tea. This would be great in the cold brew tea filter too, but it's really hard to clean inside one of these. And I was looking around, I saw Swell had a cleaner, but it was really expensive and I didn't like that it had a wooden handle. And I saw the OXO one, it had great reviews, so I decided to get a couple of these, and they just go right in the bottle. They really do a good cleaning, and yeah, sometimes you need that when you're drinking out of a water bottle. So anyway, the OXO Good Grips, that was one of my purchases this week, and I was really glad that I got it because our bottles were starting to look a little bit grotty and they're just really hard to wash out. So if you have one of these ones or the regular shape Swells or even one of the other stainless steel bottles that's out there, Nalgene containers, as I said, probably be great in the Bird and Blend or the Herio filter. So just a simple thing to have, but yeah, and a lot cheaper than the Swell brand one. Anyway, that was a jump ahead to brown paper packages, but also in tea time. Anyway, let us move on to things that are not household related or tea related. Let's get on to the fiber related goodness. This week I worked on 5 different projects, and I have to say, none of them were sweaters. I'm still in that avoidance phase, but I'm getting there. I'm getting the projects that I want to get done out of the way so that I can fully focus on those sweaters, or at least that's what I'm telling myself. So this week I grabbed one of my sock snakes and I decided that I was going to put some cuffs, heels, and toes on that sock snake. And I'm going to show you part of what I worked on now. And then I'm going to put this away and share these again in brown paper packages because I purchased something earlier this week to go with these. And if you saw my Instagram post, you will have a bit of a hint what that was, but we can wait for a few more minutes. These are the sock snakes that I created on my sock machine. And I have a bunch of them all ready for cuffs, heels, and toes. I've decided to hand knit them all in. I got some black yarn and did the cuffs and the toes. As you can see, I still need to sew in ends. And I did that on both of these socks. And I have my needles in place on both of these socks so that I can then cut in the middle, pull it back, and then start to sew in an afterthought heel. And the afterthought heel is not going to be black. So, for now, that is one of the projects that I worked on, and it took me quite a while to do this. The sock machine, I guess if I were to actually learn how to do cuffs and heels, and then most of the toe, and then you just have to Kitchener stitch the toe, I'd probably save a lot of time, but there's something nice about adding in those little touches, especially in the other colors, and I really like the ribbed cuff better than a fold-over cuff. And I don't have a ribber for my sock machine. So this is one of the projects. It's going to pop into the bag, the bin over here for a little bit later. So for brown paper packages, but that's one of the things I worked on. Another thing I worked on is my mystery project, which is in my going surfing bag, and I will share the yarn. I didn't get as far as I would have liked on this project this week, but I got a little bit more done. And this is a lovely test knit that I'm doing. I'm really enjoying it, even though I didn't spend as much time as I would have liked. It needed a bit of concentration, not a lot, but a bit. I am using this gorgeous Nora George yarns. This is Schools Out for Summer, and It is just so fun, and when you hit a little pop of neon when you're knitting it, oh, makes my heart sing. So I am hoping in the next couple of days to get this project done. It's always nice to get something off the needles, especially a test knit, and I'm not sure when this one will be released, but I think when it is, you are going to love it. So that is one of the projects that I worked on in a traditional knitting sense. It's funny that I don't really consider, even though the sock snake, I am doing some traditional knitting. It does require lots of piecework. So just, you know, working on the heels, working on the toes. It doesn't feel as much of a project as something that's in a bag. I don't know why. Here is a lovely little project that I picked up this week. A very, very simple project. I have put it in my To Kill a Mockingbird book bag. This is from Little Skein in the Big Wool. And I love this bag. It's got some beautiful floral inside. And I'm just knitting a pair of plain vanilla socks. And I have to admit, this week was really all about the socks, it seems. I am using, and I'm not sure this is going to translate as well. It's blowing out a little bit, but the blowout almost catches the color better than pulling back. It is this gorgeous green, and this is Dragonfly Fibers Into the Woods, and it is gorgeous. It's knitting up absolutely amazingly. Why do I need to throw a pair of vanilla socks on the needles, you ask, when I've got so many other things? Well, Greg and I went to the drive-in movies the other night. We saw Toy Story 4, which was great. Spoiler alert, the toys come alive, but that's all I'm going to tell you. Anyway, we went to the drive-in, and I wanted something to knit on that didn't require much thought. So the drive-in's about an hour north of Toronto, so on the way up to the theater, I worked on the cuff, and then while we were waiting for the movie and it was still light, I finished off the cuff, and then just before the movie started, I was able to start the stockinette. And I have to tell you, my gauge is really, really tight when I knit in the dark, but the fabric feels amazing. These are 72 stitches on a 2.25 needle, and these are going to be a gift. So, a bit of a surprise for someone. Not really. They know that they're going to get them. I promised them 2 years ago, so maybe it will be a surprise. But I am knitting these for someone, and I've just been wanting to get them done at some point so I can gift them. They told me that somebody made them a pair of hand-knit socks a while back, and they just didn't fit right. And I think probably what happened was the hand-knit socks that they got were more like this, where it was an afterthought heel, because he said it didn't really stretch across his instep very nicely. So I said, I'm going to make you a proper pair of socks with a heel flap and gusset. Not saying these aren't proper socks, but to me these feel like proper socks. And I asked what color he liked. He said green, and I said, I've got a gorgeous skein of green in my stash. And I do. Soon gonna be gone. And yeah, I cast this on. So this is what I did pretty much during Toy Story 4. I did a couple rounds when I got home and the next day, but like maybe three. The rest of it was done at the theater. The second movie was Aladdin, and we started watching it, and I just was feeling very tired, and I knew we had an hour drive, so we actually left shortly after Aladdin started. And when we started driving away, I looked at the clock, it was already 12:30, so I was glad that we left the movie early, because it would have been probably 3 o'clock in the morning before we got home, and that's just way too late for me. I would have turned into a pumpkin. But I did get a very good start on these socks, and these are just going to be socks that I work on when I am needing some very simple sock knitting. So I think these are going to come to Cape Cod with me, And I'll make sure I bring the darning needle so that I have the needle so that I can Kitchener stitch the toe and start the second sock. But they are knitting up really nicely. One thing about this yarn though, when I got home, my hands were green. They were very, very green. So I guess the dye from this gorgeous green transferred onto my hands. It washed up really, really nicely, which was great, not a problem. But I am going to have to make sure that I soak these really, really well, maybe 5 times, I don't know, till all the dye, excess dye has run out. Because the person I'm giving these socks to, if he didn't like having a short instep, he's certainly not going to like taking his socks off at the end of the day and having green feet. I know I wouldn't like that. It'd be a bit frightening, actually. So I know that when I'm going to be working on this, my hands are probably going to be turning a little bit green. But yeah, it'll need a really, really good soaking. So I am excited to work on these a little bit more. It just feels good to promise somebody that you're going to do something and actually start. So one project that I worked on this week, and we probably will go to the drive-in when we're in Cape Cod. So that will be a great chance to do some more simple knitting. And sometimes if we're going out for breakfast or something like that, it's nice to have a very simple project that you can work on the rounds. Of course, when I get to the heel and when I get to the gusset, I have to think a little bit more, and the toe, but a lot of this will be knitting in the round, and because it is for a man, it will be a little bit larger, 72 stitches and all. So that is project in project bag 2 that I worked on. The next project that I worked on, oh, let's stay along the line of socks, is in Grumpy Bear, and I'm going to tell you, Grumpy Bear is now grumpy because he knows that his project is done and he'll probably have to go back in the drawer for a little bit. So he's got a really good reason to be grumpy right now. But he certainly wasn't grumpy while I was finishing these socks off. Now, for this pair of socks, this is a test knit that I did for Jules, who is So Sweet Violet, and I have really been enjoying her July vlogs. And the other day, Jules and I sat down for a little bit. I pop YouTube up on the TV through Apple TV, and I have all my subscriptions through my personal YouTube account, so we just pop it on the TV and watch. So it was nice watching Jules and knitting away on her second sock. So these are the Mabel socks. And for the Mabel socks, I use this gorgeous orange, and there's not much left, as the heels and the toes. And then the main color, I used this gorgeous skein of Little Spruce. My brain almost escaped me there for a moment. And both of these yarns are Nora George Yarn Super Sock, which if you've tuned in before, you know I love using Nora George yarns. So there is my leftover yarn. There's enough there to do something else with. And I now have 2 Mabel socks. And when I did the pattern back in the spring, this is a test knit that I did, and I had said to Jules, I really can only get one done by the deadline, and then I'm probably going to have to do the second sock once I'm on holiday. They're done, and oh my gosh, it feels so good to get that second sock done, especially when it's a test knit, and you know, it's just nice having them photographed together, but it was really good having them off the needles. Now, one of the things that had happened when I knit my first sock was I was on jury duty, and every time we'd go back into the deliberation room, I'd have a chance to pick up my knitting. And I think that was where I got into the cuff and I just stopped reading the directions, which is not a good thing when you're test knitting. And I just did the cuff thinking it was all twisted rib, but I forgot to add in the little Mabel cable that is in the cuff here. And then I realized it after it was cast off, and I thought, oh, do I really want to go back and put in a Mabel cable? Yes and no. I did it. And so once I finished the second sock, I went back and I pulled back the cuff to the end of where the sock was. And so I have the main color, and then I'm poor Grumpy Bear. He's gonna be, oh, here it is. He fell out. And this was actually the previous cuff. I just pulled it off, cut it, because I didn't wanna play yarn chicken or have to add in a new yarn start, weave in a new yarn halfway through the cuff. So I just decided to cut and go straight from where the cuff began with new yarn. So that is what I did, and all my ends are now sewn in, and these have the lovely beanie toe. They've got the Mabel's cables going up both sides and into the cuff. They've got a twisted rib cuff for the most part, except for, of course, the Mabel's cable. And then they have a short row heel. These are toe-up socks. I am not as strong on toe-up socks as I am top-down. And my heel really, I think, leaves a lot to be desired. I think I need to pull tighter when I'm doing my German short row heels, but practice makes perfect, right? That's just gotta keep doing those heels. But I really prefer the top down, and but these are so fun, and the colors are summery. Now I am not probably going to wear these anytime in July, but these are the perfect socks to wear on those yucky blah February days when you want that shot of color and you're just feeling those winter blahs. Pulling out a pair of summer socks is a fabulous thing to do. So Mabel socks are done. Grumpy Bear is grumpy because he knows he's going to be emptied out of his yarn, and then he's going to be folded nicely and put in the drawer for another project. But he was lovely to work with, because Grumpy Bear is always lovely to work with. The final project that I am going to share with you is in my, I'm going to call this my happy homemaker bag, the Pyrex containers. It's a bird leg bag. It's got a lovely little bobble pull on it. Inside this bag is just a fun little fabric as well. Lots of little diamond patterns there that coordinate. And this is the My Chrysalis shawl, and I shared the pattern last week. It is by Lavanya Petroselli, I think it is. I don't have my glasses, I just know it starts with a P, and I'm going to write it there because it's just so much better. So this is the My Chrysalis shawl, and it is a lovely mixture of the Surrey alpaca yarn and singles, and I'm trying to remember the name, and I did the same thing last week too where I had to peek. The Surrey blend for Ching Fibers is called Melted Surrey. So I'm using Melted Surrey, and I am using Merino Single, and there's not an S on single there, it's just Merino Single. And then this one is Melted Surrey. And let's show the yarn. So my Melted Surrey is this fun, fluffy black and neon pops of color in just, oh, such soft, soft yarn. It's been really nice to work with. So this is Miss Bim. I don't know who Miss Bim is. I looked it up. I got some weird Google responses. I don't want to look farther. Anyway, this is Miss Bim, and she will do. And then I am also using Sky Blue in the Merino single, and it's got little tiny pops of color. A big, huge hawk just flew across my front yard. The hawks are back. The cat is in the house. She's an indoor cat, but sometimes she slips out, so we need to be careful when it's hawk season. And they've been crying a lot. They're hungry. Anyway, this is the Sky Blue in the Merino single. Now let's get to, and this is the skein that I'm using of the Melted Surrey. I have a second skein for later on. And the colors are working up so nicely together. Apparently people think the Honda Indy is going down my street. I live on a quiet, residential, one-way street, fairly central. But sometimes people just zoom. I guess they don't think the kids live on the street. I don't know, but sometimes it's really annoying. Anyway, this is the My Chrysalis shawl. And it is a mixture of eyelets and brioche and back to eyelets again. And I'm about to start another brioche section. And last week, I left you where the dragon is, right here. So I just started the brioche. I had done about this much. And this week I have gotten a little bit further. I'm trying to find where the dragon is. I can't see the dragon on the, it's right. The problem with using a blue dragon is he blends in. So, there is the blue dragon, and I am really enjoying this shawl. It's nice to work on, very simple, and I'm just going to, I had another pink dragon. Here is the pink dragon. Somehow she had jumped off of the tray. I am going to pop her onto the spot where my needle is, and if you see, here to here was how much I did this week. So, not bad if I do say so myself. I have been enjoying this knit. I think that Isaac is really going to love having this as a warm thing around his neck because I am making this for him. And yeah, it's been a bit of a diversion from some of the socks that I've been working on. So, anyway, squishy, lovely. Whenever I get to one of the neon-y colors, there's just gorgeous, gorgeous brights in there. Again, makes my heart sing. I love bright colors. I really, really do. Anyway, this will go away for a little bit. And look at that fluff. So, so fluffy. And pop this in my happy homemaker bag. I'm not sure that this is going to come to Cape Cod with me. I think I will work on it a little bit this week. But I don't think I'm going to bring this one to the sand and the surf. Can you imagine that Surrey with all that sand just from working on the beach? I think I'm going to leave this one at home. But yeah, that's gotten some good love this week, so that makes me happy. I have one more thing to share on my favorite things, and it's a little bit different because what I'm going to share is actually a finished object and some yarn that I've had in my stash for a little while. And I am going to share with you my 100 Acre Wood shawl, and I may have shared this on one of the earlier episodes. It is one of my favorite shawls that I've knit, and this was a test knit that I did for Helen Stewart, who is Curious Handmade, and it is the 100 Acre Wood. It was a collaboration that Helen did with Anne, who is Little Skein in the Big Wool, and oh my goodness, I absolutely adore this shawl. And this is knit London Cosmopolitan, a colorway by Madeline Tosh, which is available exclusively at Loop London. And it's also knit another Madeline Tosh yarns with Kitten. And the pink and the grayish brown are absolutely amazing together. And I'd say it's probably more gray than brown, but I absolutely adore this shawl. And I was having a little chat with Anne through a DM, and I was saying about how much I love this shawl, and I thought, you know what, I think I might actually knit it while I'm on holiday. And Anne said, yeah, that would be a great idea. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And I've had a couple of people in their Instagram put out any shawl recommendations. I've got this yarn, any shawl recommendations? And I have recommended to a couple of people that, oh, the 100 Acre Wood is great, probably because it's so much in my mind. And it is really one of my favorite shawls. It's got the gorgeous bit of striping. It has this gorgeous little eyelet honeypot section with little garter ridges. And then it's got a little section of slip stitches back to some eyelets, and then slip stitches, and then a lovely little eyelet striped border. And oh, I love this one. I really do. And I've been wanting to knit another one. So let's go into my stash. And as I said, sort of a not quite brown paper packages. This has been in my stash for a while. I bought this gorgeous Scout bag last year while we were in Cape Cod. And it's a fun bag. It's nice, it'll be waterproof, perfect for the beach. And it's got all the things that you need when you are going camping. So it's exactly what I need to take camping, no electricity for 2 weeks with us, with our tent. I think it'll be a good bag. Anyway, I was gifted the skeins from Little Skein and the Big Wool after I test knit this shawl. So Helen sent these to me. I've got a bit of an itchy on my nose. I think it was from all the surrey and then wrapping. This is not normally itchy, but just, I think I've got a bit of a, yeah, I had a hair in my, got a hair falling down. Anyway, Helen gifted me the Willy Wonka yarn that was used as her sample, and it was the gradient version. And I have had this yarn in my stash for a couple of years, waiting to be knit up. And this is what I'm going to work on while I am on holiday. And the reason that I brought this shawl down and brought this yarn to share with you is that I am wondering if anyone else would like to join in on a mini knit along on the 100 Acre Wood shawl. And if you would, I would love it if you would join in. And you can message me on Ravelry or DM me on Instagram. We do have a Comfy Red Couch group, that's what the word is, group in Ravelry, but I know not a lot of stuff has been going on there, so I could probably open a little chat discussion area there. While I'm away, I probably won't, I'll be in a campground without electricity, definitely without Wi-Fi, so I will be checking in every once in a while, but while I'm away, I probably won't be as on the internet as I am when I am at home. So anyway, these are the yarns I'm going to use to knit my second 100 Acre Wood shawl, which I've been dying to do for so long. And I would definitely be excited if you would join along with me. Now, my big question though is, what order do I knit my gradient set in? So Helen's sample, which is absolutely gorgeous, is knit A, B, C, D, and then, good catch, E. So that is the order. I am wondering if, and probably when you're, I'm doing it backwards for you, so it really should be A, B, C, D, and then the dark one, E. I am wondering whether I should start with green at the top and end with purple at the bottom. I think it would probably look great either way, but there's always something when you see the sample, you know exactly how it's going to turn out. And this is last week when I talked about doubting myself when I was knitting the Shawl Society pattern 3 and my yarn choices. I am doubting myself on this one. I've always thought that maybe I should knit it backwards from the sample. I'm not sure. I'd love to know what you think. Anyway, this is what I am going to use for my 100 Acre Wood shawl, and I would absolutely love it if you would join along. I know the lovely Alice has started a 100 Acre Wood shawl yesterday, and Alice was small mermaids, but she just changed her Instagram name and her name on YouTube as well. She just started a YouTube channel. Nathaniel really enjoyed watching the avocado YouTube video that Alice put up on how to grow an avocado, and he loves avocados. So he has got his two avocado seeds, and we had a jar of hot peppers in the fridge. He ate those for breakfast yesterday because he wanted the jar. He was so desperate. So anyway, we have all the things we need to start growing our own avocado plant. And I think when he gets home today, we'll have to start the avocado plants. I don't know how Isaac will be home, so I guess he'll have to keep monitoring the avocado plants while we're away. Anyway, 100 Acre Wood Shawl, if you would like to join in, I would love to have you knit along with me and see your progress either in the Ravelry group or if you want to DM me a photograph. I just think it would just be such a lovely, fun knit. And I know how much I love and wear this version of my 100 Acre Wood shawl. And I do love these colors, but the gradient, loving as well. Anyway, that is all I have for my favorite things this week, and it will be a little bit slim pickings in brown paper packages, but that's okay. This week is a fairly quiet week on brown paper packages. The only thing that I really received in the mail was this cleaning tool for the water bottles. Definitely something important to have, especially when I have a water bottle or two or three. Isaac has a couple of water bottles and he takes them to work with him. And Nathaniel, of course, has a water bottle too. So important to be able to clean them properly and efficiently. And I have to say, it works really well. So I was glad that I did get those. Now, the other project that I shared and I said I would bring into brown paper packages, those were my sock snake, and I realized I didn't tell you what yarn I used, so I'm going to do that now. So this is a sock snake that I made using Nora George Yarns. This is the Hufflepuff Micro Stripe, and I tensioned the yarn a little bit looser on the machine because these are for Isaac. And I'm trying to get some of the sock snakes done. And so when I talked about holiday knitting, I think I'm going to try and take a couple sock snakes with me as well to get some more socks done so that when he goes to college, he can take them with him. So I just used a plain black ball of yarn that I had, and it's a German sock yarn that I've had in my stash for a little bit. And I did the cuffs and the toes with the black. And plain black. Last weekend, I bought a skein of Mondim in yellow. I know, crazy, but I thought it would look really fantastic as heels, especially with the black toes and cuffs. Plus, some of the Knit Pick sock snakes that I have yellow in it. And when I was looking at the colors, I've heard that the Mondim is really great for socks. And I thought it was something interesting to try. And I got this at the Knitting Loft in Toronto, and the Knitting Loft carries the Mondeem in, I think they have all of the colors. So I picked up yellow, and this one is just color 107, I think it is, and 107, C-O-R, I'm thinking color, 107, and I think it will be fantastic as heels in these socks. So goal this week is to sew in all my ends and put in some heels and then get these all nice and blocked ready for Isaac to take away. And they are squishy and just been fun to work on these. Now, these are for Isaac. I have this yarn and I still have some of the snake left. And Nathaniel, who is notoriously bad with socks, as soon as he walks in the door, the socks are off his feet. He doesn't like to wear them, but he says he does want a pair of Hufflepuff socks. So I have a little bit of a sock snake left that I can make him some smaller socks because he's got smaller feet. And I think these should probably be good. So I will cut it around here. And what I did with the last pair was I just put my needles in. I put two sets of needles in and then I was able to separate and then I had them already on the needles and was able to start knitting. On the ends, I just have to take my waste yarn out and then pop in my needles. And then here I just need to pop in the needles so that I can get the heels and the cuffs done, the toes and the cuffs done first, and then once I've got that done and I've got a nice solid sock like I do with these ones, I'll then get ready to pop the heels in. And Nathaniel has asked for the same combination as Isaac with the black toes and cuffs and then the yellow heels. Although I think I might be tempted just to do all yellow for him. Wouldn't it be kind of nice to do the yellow cuffs, yellow toes, and black heels? Just to have those reversed ones. Not that my boys are ever going to confuse their socks because Isaac has big monster feet while Nathaniel has much smaller feet. Although his feet are pretty big for a 10-year-old, almost 10-year-old. I'm thinking when Isaac was young, he had smaller feet than Nathaniel has now, but Isaac is wearing a 12 shoe size, 11 and a half, 12 shoe size now. He's got really big puppy feet. And Nathaniel has smaller puppy feet, which will grow bigger. Anyway, that is leftover, and this was my yarn purchase for the week. But I don't quite have an empty bag. Because while I was out this week, last Sunday, I said we went to a family event and we had a lovely afternoon. Traffic was really, really terrible. It normally takes us an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours to get to St. Catharines, which is near Niagara Falls, and that's where Greg's family, a lot of them live. It took us 3 hours, which was crazy. Anyway, my sister-in-law had this really fun bag that she had popped everything into, and I said, that's a great bag, and I knew Isaac would love it, and I thought that would be really great to pop in some things for the beach. And she said, I got it at Indigo, which is the bookstore in Canada, and it was on sale. So I picked up a lovely striped fluorescent, I guess rainbowish, bag from Indigo, and I think this will be really fantastic to pop all of my projects that I am taking to Cape Cod with me. And so let us start off by, here is one project bag ready to go in here. The next project bag is, I thought it was there, but maybe it's not. I also have my sweater that I'm going to work on, which is going to go in here. I am going to pop the green socks in here, although I might work on these a little bit this week. And whatever I can fit in this bag is all the knitting I'm allowed to take. I said I was only going to take three projects. I was going to take a very simple knitting in the round type of project, so that's one of them. I decided I'm going to take the 100 Acre Wood, and then I'm also going to take my boxy cardigan. And I may pop in one more project. I know, one more than three. But I think this one was always a thought to come along. But I think I'm going to pop in another pair of socks. We shall see. All up for debate. But a sweater, a shawl, definitely one pair of socks. And I think that will be great holiday knitting. So, a wonderful beachy bag to take all of my knitting on my holiday, because that's an important thing to pack. But that leaves me with an empty basket for brown paper packages, and that's okay. At this point, I have lots to keep me busy, but it probably really was good to get a fun color to do some heels and toes. Oh yes, and I'm gonna throw some sock snakes into this bag too. So I'm taking a little bit more than I had originally thought. I think if I bring two sock snakes, that will be enough. That's all I think my brain can handle. Anyway, that is all I have for brown paper packages. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And we got two new red chairs this week, which really helps to open the space up. The poor dingy white couch, we had to say goodbye. Nathaniel was very, very upset because even though it was very dingy, it was a comfortable couch. Although I have to say, every time I'd walk by, he'd have thrown most of the cushions on the ground, which would drive me crazy. He can't do that on the new chairs, although he does want a couple of nice accent pillows. So I might indulge him. Maybe while we're in Cape Cod, I'll find something that will match well and will also be a nice little reminder of our holiday. There's nice little shops, but there's one in particular that I think would maybe have something that will hopefully fit the bill. But I'm not going to rush out and buy accent cushions at this moment. I think I'll let him help me with that while we're away. And then that way maybe he'll feel a little bit more happy with the chairs. He was really, really upset about the couch going out. But yeah, it was great. They called on Friday and said the chairs are in. Isaac came with me to pick them up, and then we had to put them together because the legs had to be put on and then the back had to be put in place. But yeah, they're a good fit for this area, and this is our main living space, so feels good. Feels really good to just have something that is functional. The cat loves the chairs. Scout, I don't think, has tried to get on them, and I hope she doesn't, but she likes to sometimes come up here by me, and that's okay. And what else happened this week? Yesterday I went out for a lovely high tea with family and my best friend, and we were just having a lovely afternoon out, and we enjoyed lots of sandwiches and goodies and scones with clotted cream and jam, and it was a very indulgent afternoon for sure. And afterwards I stopped by a friend's place on the way home and had a lovely visit with him and his mother and his brother and his cousin were there, so we had a lovely little catch up. He used to be our neighbor, and he's our plumber actually, and he's just one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. But he moved, which makes me sad, and he's not terribly far away, but I don't get out there as often as I should, so it was really nice I came home because of the crazy traffic in Toronto with the Honda Indy this weekend, I decided to take one of the city roads home. And by taking that city road home, I was able to stop by and visit our friend. And it was just a nice diversion for sure. So it was a lovely Saturday afternoon. I have been on holiday. I'm just jumping all around, working on things, doing little things around the house. I've not gotten up to too many exciting things. I'm still very much in just recuperation mode, and I'm not sure why it's taking me so long to finally get settled. We are supposed to go to, and I say supposed to, isn't that bad? We are going to Cape Cod next week. Our reservation starts next Sunday, so a week today. But I'm just not feeling it. And I know once I get there, it'll all be, I need to go and I need to get that grounding, be out in nature. But I guess packing up all the tent stuff, all the camping gear, and just the drive, it's a long drive. And luckily I'm not doing it on my own. The original thought was that we were going to borrow my parents' trailer, but we really would prefer to take our own car, and we can't hook the trailer up to our car. Even though we have a jack, you need a brake system on it, and we don't have that, and it would cost way too much. So we're not going to borrow my parents' trailer. We're just going to take our tent, which is a lovely tent. It's a big tent. It's a high tent. It's a great tent. And then just try and take the minimal things. This year, I will, when we pack the camp stove, make sure we have the attachments so that we can actually use the camp stove. Big mistake last year. Really, really big mistake. I like to do my style of glamping, and my style of glamping is we have this really big tent. It's got high ceiling. It's a 12 by 15 tent, so it's really quite large inside. We do have beds that are off the ground because I don't like sleeping on the ground, so that's my style of glamping. I've got an air bed, and Nathaniel and Isaac, when they are both with us, but it will only be Nathaniel, have bunk beds that are fantastic. And now we're at the point where Nathaniel sleeps on the top bunk and Isaac sleeps on the bottom bunk just because they're so different in size. But we'll only be bringing one of the beds for Nathaniel and then our blow-up bed for us, so that I'm off the ground. And my style of glamping is I get one meal out a day. So we can cook hot dogs and other things. I prefer breakfast. Breakfast out is my favorite. But yeah, gearing up to go camping has been a little bit challenging this year, and I'm not sure why. But I'm sure once I'm going, I'll be ready to go. Lots of packing to do. Anyway, I am thinking I am going to podcast a little bit earlier this week. I may record my podcast on Wednesday or maybe Thursday. And that's because we will probably leave Friday or Saturday. And I want to share the Shawl Society 3 with you. And it will be released on the 18th. So I definitely don't want to leave you without seeing the third pattern before I go on holiday. And then when I'm on holiday, I will maybe take a little bit of footage, but there will not be a podcast for at least a couple of weeks. But I'm really looking forward to, when I come back, sharing the progress that I've gotten up to on my projects and my sweater, hopefully. Hopefully I will brave up and start knitting on that sweater. The kids, Isaac has been working every single day. He's been working really, really hard. He works mainly afternoons to the evening shift, and he's been instructing swimming and lifeguarding, and I think he's been enjoying it, but it is every day, so it does get tiring. He had a lovely visit with one of his friends last night. He was invited for dinner and he took a dessert with him. So he made trifle and took that with him, and I think it was enjoyed. Nathaniel got to go out with one of his friends earlier this week to a place called Wet and Wild, and it's a place that has water slides, and I think he had a really good time too. But otherwise, I think we've just been enjoying quiet time in the summer and just hanging about, trying to steel ourselves up for sweaters and camping and all of those things. But it's been nice just having some time off for sure. Anyway, I think that's all I've got for bits and bobs. Nothing too exciting is happening. Greg starts his holiday later this week, and that will be nice to have some time just to have some family time and get myself ready to go camping. Anyway, yeah, that's all I've got for bits and bobs this week. Thank you so much for joining me on the comfy red couch this week, or whether you chose to sit on the comfy red chairs. Wherever you are, I am happy that you took some time out of your day to join me. And I hope that you got a chance to work on your project of choice, that you had a lovely beverage, and that you enjoyed watching some of the projects that I have been working on grow, the ones that I'm allowed to share. And I'm just thankful that you took some time to spend with me. Have a lovely week ahead. As I said, I will see you a little bit earlier than I normally do before I take a little bit of a holiday. And I'm very, very excited to share Shawl 3 from the Shawl Society with you later this week. But for now, I've got some knitting to get done. I would like to finish one of the projects that I shared with you, and then I'd like to maybe do a little bit of work on some of the whips that I have going on in Ravelry. I'm now down to 3 lines of whips, so that's, I think I'm at 11 whips. That's a lot for me, so I would like, and 2 of them are actually finished objects just waiting to be released. But when I see those 3 lines, it makes me start feeling like I need to start paying attention to those projects. So I have a couple of projects over to my left here that I would like to maybe pick up this week, spend a little bit of time on before I go on holiday, and get those striped socks done so that we've got those done as well. At least just the 1 pair. I don't think I'll get the 2nd pair done, maybe while I'm away. But yeah, I've got a lot to keep me busy for sure. Anyway, I'm wishing you a wonderful week ahead, and I look forward to seeing you later this week. Bye. Part of the reason I've been so hesitant about the camping trip is I know how much packing of equipment and clothes and items needs to happen. But really, I have started the most important packing of my trip anyway, and that is my knitting bag. Because of course, whenever you go on a trip, the most important bag that you take is your knitting bag and all the project bags inside. So I've got a good start. A few more things to add to this, but yeah, the packing has begun.